woke up this morning about 5 o'clock. I woke up and I heard this as I woke up. No time for slackers. So turn in your Bibles to Matthew chapter 24. And we're basically gonna just teach out of Matthew 24 this morning. And the subject is no time for slacker. Do you know when I say a slacker is someone that may have been doing good, but then they just decide, start slacking off. You know, just begin to get I don't care attitude. You know, and just begin to kind of not do their best anymore. You know, a slacker is somebody that could pick that piece of paper up, but just let it go, you know. Slacker is just slacking off with, you know, you was charging, and then all of a sudden you just start slacking off, you know. Mm-hmm. But this is no time for slacker. And we're going to be coming out of Matthew 24. And you know, God knows what he wants to preach, and God knows who he needs to preach it to.
Amen.
And so, you know, a lot of times when I get a word like this, I'm thinking, well, my people are not slackers. But God knows who he wants to preach to, and God knows who he wants to bring a word to. And it may be somebody through the camera, you know. Or it may be us.
Amen.
You know, just because we think that we're here every Sunday and we're charging, we can always do better.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
We can always do better.
Yeah, and always do better.
But the subject mainly is growing cold on the things of God right here at the end time, at the end. You see, that's another thing a slacker is, what I said. You know, all day long, he's been going, he's been working hard, he's been going and doing things, you know. And when you're working, and you're on a job working, and you work 10 hours a day, and nine hours of it, you've been hard at it, and you know 10 hours are coming, and they still needing 100% of you in your life. Well, my gosh, They've got 100% out of me 9 hours. I think I'm gonna just cool, kind of chill for a little while, get ready to go home.
Come on, yeah.
You know, that's a slacker.
Yeah.
He's been hard at it all day, but right there at the end of the day, like, I tell you what, I've been so hard at this. You know, hey, I've been there.
Yeah.
I know. I've worked 10 hours a day, and I mean. Charging, you know, burning 100-pound rod a day, you know, trying to just get the job done, you know, and then just burn out at the end of the day, you know. Here we are at the end of the times coming.
Well.
And, you know, some of us been serving God for 30 and 40 years, you know, and sometimes we get to feeling like, what's the use? What's the use? But we can't let that happen.
Right.
We got to keep the foot on the pedal. It don't matter if there's curves in the road. We got to handle those curves.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. We got to stay going at it. You can't win the race by slacking off.
Yeah.
If you slack off, you're not going to cross the finish line.
Come on.
You got to stay pedal to the metal. Amen?
Amen. Yeah.
Matthew 24. Jesus left the temple and was walking away when his disciples came up to him to call his attention to its building. Jesus said, "Do you see all these things? I tell you the truth, not one stone here will be left upon another. Everyone will be thrown down. As Jesus was sitting on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately. Tell us, they said, when will this happen, and what will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age? And Jesus answered, I'm reading out of the NIV. Watch out that no one deceives you, for many will come in my name, claiming I am the Christ, and will deceive many. Now right there, many will come in my name and deceive many. And folks, how many of us know that today, because this just jumped out to me this morning, you know, we hear that many will come in my name and deceive many by claiming that they're the Christ. You know, for so long I thought about, you know, whether, you know, that's these people that, you know, that you've had the Jim Joneses and the different ones of them, you know, that these people that's followed and it was all cults, you know, and that happens. But there is many of people is being deceived today by being led down a road of false teaching.
Come on, yeah.
Easy believing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Are you hearing?
Yeah.
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 They're being deceived by making them believe that they're all right in their sin.
Yeah. Come on. Yeah.
A lot of people go to church every Sunday and live a sinful life.
Yeah.
And they think they're all right. They're being deceived.
Yeah.
They're being deceived by people getting up and preaching and whitewashing the gospel.
Come on. Yeah.
Whitewashing it and making it a greasy grace, making it feel like that they're okay in their sin.
Yeah.
You can't do that.
Amen.
You've got to stay focused. You've got to stay going strong hard. Amen. Watch out that no one deceives you, for many will come in my name, claiming I am the Christ, and will deceive many. You will hear of wars and rumors of wars, but see to it that you are not alarmed. Such things must happen, but the end is still to come. Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be famine and earthquakes in various places. All these things are the beginning of birth pains. All these things is happening right now. Mm-hmm. Every bit of it has been happening. Mm-hmm. And it says it's the beginning of birth pains. But here's the thing, folks. This is no time for slackers. Why? Because we're not in the beginnings of birth pains. We're in the ending of birth pains, I believe. See, all of these things that he's talking about has been going on basically since he talked about that.
Yeah.
But everybody knows that birth pains get more and more intense the closer to the time of birth.
Yeah.
Such as many, 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 many more earthquakes happening. Many, many more volcanoes erupting. People getting so cold to the gospel.
Yeah. Cold to life.
Cold to life. There's famines everywhere. Everywhere we hear. I mean, look, you know, famine is all over this earth. That's a sign of the times of the coming of Jesus.
Yeah, man.
And you know, we need to be aware of all of that. And then read on here, it says, then you will be handed over to be persecuted and put to death, and you will be hated by all nations because of me. Every nation in the world right now, the only name that they hate more than anything else is Jesus.
That's right.
The only name that they hate, that America hates more than Trump, is Jesus.
Yeah.
In every other country. And if you stand for that name, if you have that name on you, and when when I say it's on you, it should be on you.
Yeah.
You should be covered with that name. If you're a believer in Jesus Christ, you should be covered with that name. And it should not take them long to figure out that you are a follower of Jesus.
Come on.
It should show on you.
Yes.
If people can't see that you're a follower of Jesus by what you by your lifestyle, and I'm not talking about having signs hanging all over you saying I'm a follower of Jesus.
Come on.
I'm talking about you living normal, everyday life, and you ain't got no kind of sign on you, but people know that you are a follower of Jesus.
Yeah.
And the more they realize that you're a follower of Jesus, they're either one going to cling to you or they're going to hate you.
Yeah.
There's not going to be no in between.
Right.
Yeah. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. And you will be hated by all nations because of me. At that time, many will turn away from the faith and will betray and hate each other. And many false prophets will appear and deceive many people. Because of the increase of wickedness, the love of most will grow cold. And that's exactly what's happening today.
Yeah.
I mean, I remember when I was a kid, people had love in their heart for their fellow man.
They don't have that.
They don't have it.
They're perfectly willing to kill babies.
They kill babies. They're perfectly willing to kill you.
Yeah.
If you don't see things the way that they see them, they just soon kill you.
Mm-hmm.
If you're wearing something that they don't like, they just soon kill you.
Yeah.
And that's where we at today, folks. This is no time to be slacking off, and so many people are slacking off.
Yeah.
So many people are having the attitude of Jesus is so far away from coming. And they don't realize that it's so close at hand.
Yeah.
And there's so many people. I believe with all my heart, I believe this, that if Jesus comes on a Sunday morning, there's going to be a lot of churches that very few is going to leave out of. Now, I'm not saying that judgmental. I'm just saying that unless a church changes, I'm mostly talking about the church here in America. Unless a church changes its attitude. Because, you know, the church in general, I believe here in America, is taking its foot off of the accelerator and just coasting along and letting whatever go. Would you want to be a homosexual? That's fine. I mean, we've gone so far here in America that some churches are even ordaining homosexuals. They're even marrying them and blessing those unities. Are you hearing?
Yeah.
That's slacking off.
Yeah.
That's slacking off. Just because it's politically correct, we slack off of it.
Come on.
Oh, well. Okay. And we let it go. Well, we don't want to upset nobody. So, you know, if you wanna live with your concubine, you know, well, yeah, come on to church, you know. It's all right, you know. Instead of telling them you're living in sin.
Right.
Instead of telling them, well, you know, why you want to wonder why you can't get ahead. You want to wonder why nothing works for you. You want to wonder why every time you turn around something's going wrong. It's because you're out there living in the enemy's territory.
Yep.
You're living in sin.
Come on.
And you're out from under the shadow of the Most High.
Come on.
Amen.
Amen.
When you get under the shadow of the Most High, you can trust in Him.
Yes, that's right.
But you can't live in sin. I like what I like what somebody posted the other day, if I can remember it correctly, said you can't live with the devil all through the week and expect God to pay the rent.
Yeah.
Something like that. But that's the way people want it nowadays. You know, they want to say that they've got God in their life, but they want to have all this other trash in their life too. Well, I've got news for you. You can't have it both ways.
Yeah, that's right.
God wants all of you. And if you don't want all of him and all of you to be with him, then he still wants you, but he's not going to force you to be there. And he's not going to be there with you in your sin.
That's right.
If I'm saying it right.
Yep, that's right.
You hear it? Anyway, but he who stands firm to the end will be saved. And this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in all the world as a testimony to all nations, and then the end will come. And then I'm going to jump on ahead a little bit here to, let's see, where was I at there? I ain't even. I'm going to go ahead and read all the way. So when you see standing in the holy place the abomination of that causes desolation spoken through the prophet Daniel, let the reader understand. Then let those who are in Judah flee to the mountains. Let no one on the roof of his house go down to take anything out of the house. Let no one in the field go back to get his cloak. How dreadful it will be in those days for pregnant women and nursing mothers. Pray that your flight will not take place in winter or on the Sabbath. For then there will be great distress, unequal from the beginning of the world until now, and never to be equal again. If those days had not been cut short, no one would survive, but for the sake of the elect, those days will be shortened. At that time, if anyone says to you, look, here is the Christ, or there he is, do not believe it. For false Christs and false prophets will appear and perform great signs and miracles and deceive even the elect if that were possible. See, I have told you ahead of time. Now, right there, performing great signs and miracles. How many folks, and I say, you know, there's been times that we've almost gone so far as to doing this. We hear about signs and wonders happening in a certain place, you know. Oh, they're doing this over there, and they lay home sick, and all kind of signs and wonders is happening, and we start chasing over there. And we start chasing over here, you know. and people will say, well, this minister's doing this, and we start chasing over there and going, are you hearing me? That's how you're going to be deceived.
Come on.
When you start following after signs and wonders, whenever you start following, you know, just because this fella's doing this, and we start, oh, we just, everything's going that way.
Yeah.
You know, we can almost get caught up in that ourselves, folks.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, we have certain people that we're most fond of, you know. I've been guilty of the same thing. And we tend to want to just stay going to them, you know. And that's fine. They do have true words. You know, I'm thinking of several right now, you know, that from time to time we've thrown everything down just so we can go hear them. You know. Want to go hear this person. They're going to be doing this, you know. And that's okay, but you got to keep it in perspective.
Yeah.
In doing that, you're going to hear from God, you're not going to hear from so-and-so.
That's right.
You're going to get, you know they bring the word good, and that's great, and you're going to hear the word of God.
Yeah, that's right.
And you're wanting that.
Right. Amen.
But you got to always be listening, because even the perfect person that we think is good, if you don't, even then, I can slip and make something a false statement. You know, but if I do, and you hear it down here, like, listen to that.
Yeah.
That's your guide.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You see, and I'm putting myself in that place too, because I can make a false statement. She can make a false statement.
Yeah.
We're human. God is perfect, but he works through imperfect vessels. So don't put your trust in that man that you're listening to. Put your trust in the Holy Spirit guiding you.
Yeah. Amen.
And if he says, that's a bone, throw that out. If he says, that's a piece of stubble, throw that away. Spit it out.
Yeah.
That's how you keep from being deceived.
Yes.
And as long as you're doing that, you're not slacking off. You've got the foot to the pedal and you're just pushing on.
Amen.
Because there's times that we're going to hear things, you know, just like the other night when we was reading in that book. There was a few things in there that I'm not completely sold on. But at the same time, all of it's really good, and I'm not saying that he's a false prophet and I ain't following him. You know, I'm not following him, I'm following Jesus. But there's a few things in there that he sees it a little bit differently than I do.
Yeah.
Are you hearing me? And I'm not saying what it is, because you know all of y'all have got to decide on yourself what those things are. There's just a few things that I've kind of put on the shelf.
Yeah.
Not saying he's wrong or right, I've just got him on the shelf right now. I see him a little bit different, you see. And if you're doing that, you're not going to be deceived.
That's right.
Amen.
You see? Mm-hmm. Because you got your eyes on Jesus.
Right.
And you're listening, you're waiting for the leading of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
That's what I'm trying to bring out here is, when people start following these signs and wonders, the devil will accompany you. If we have to have signs and wonders to show us that that's of Jesus.
Yeah.
Because how many of you know, Moses threw his rod down and it became a snake. But then the magicians throw theirs down and they became a snake.
Mm-hmm.
But then God showed up again and said, okay, and he ate all of them. But what I'm saying is, the devil can perform miraculous things.
Yep.
And he said, it's even possible to deceive, if it were possible to deceive even the very elect. Now, why do you think he said that?
That's how strong the deception will be.
That's right. But here's the thing. If it were possible, why is it not possible for the very elect to be deceived? Because the very elect has their eyes on Jesus and they're listening to him.
Yeah.
And another they will not follow.
Yeah.
That's right.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
That's why it's not possible for the elect to be deceived.
No matter how strong it is.
That's right. Because they know.
Yeah.
That woman knows I'm her husband. And another, she knows it ain't going to be. And I know she's my wife. And another, I'm not going to be deceived by it.
Right.
She's talking to me. I know it's her on the end of the phone. I may not see her, but I know it's her. Mm-hmm. And vice versa. You know?
Yeah.
and I said it that way because that's what we are. The elect is the bride of Christ.
The bride of Christ. Yes.
He said, my people know my voice, and another they will not follow. That's why you can't be deceived if you're the elect.
Amen.
Because you know his voice, and you're not going to follow anything else. But if you start slacking off, and when you slacking off, this is a sign of slacking off when you go to listening for other things.
Yeah.
You know, when you hear this going on, and you begin to kind of turn your ear to that, saying, no, I know that's not God, and I ain't fooling with that, you know. Sometimes the best thing you to do is just say, nope, I ain't fooling with that. Don't care how good it sounds.
Amen.
There's decisions like that's got to be made. Because if you go to consider things sometimes, that's all the devil needs to deceive you. Is you just go to consider things. When you got your foot to the pedal and you're looking straight forward, you're not going to consider making that little alternate exit there because, no, I can't do that. I'm going too fast. I got to stay straight ahead because I know that's the way I'm supposed to go. And if I make this left, I'm going to wreck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But they're saying it's a better way. Yeah, but they're saying it's a little shorter. No, I got to stay straight ahead.
Amen.
All you got to do is let off the pedal a little bit and make that left turn. And when you make that left turn, it's going to get easier.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Are you hearing me?
Mm-hmm.
You slacked off a little bit, but you're supposed to be going straight ahead. Yeah, but the longer you go, the more narrow that road's going to get.
Yeah.
The further you go on this road, the more narrow it's going to get. You go over here, you got plenty of room to travel.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Amen.
That's what a slacker does. He looks over there and, oh, well, that looks a little easier. Oh, I think I'll take that path.
Come on.
See, we can't do that. We got to stay on straight and narrow. And the further it goes, the more narrow it gets.
Yep.
Because, folks, there's a lot of things that's on us right now that need to get off.
Yeah.
Because the narrower it goes, the more things you got to get rid of.
Yep. Right. You have to.
When you cross that finish line, there ain't none of that trash can go across it with you.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
What did it say right here? And this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in the whole world as a testimony to all nations. And then the end will come. That's not what I'm talking about. It's talking about the one that something about. Maybe I'm getting ahead of myself here. Something about the stay until the end. Anyway, but it stay until the end and you'll be saved. Amen?
Amen.
I thought about going through this whole chapter, but I believe I'm going to just stop right there. Because I actually preached on a lot of this a couple weeks ago, what's on further down there in Day of Nowhere. Go ahead and stand your feet.